Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I have an eyeshadow palette haul. I don't know, lately I've been buying a lot of eyeshadow palettes, so I figured we do a haul. I'm also gonna finish off with a couple of palettes I've received in PR lately because they are newer to the market, but the main focus is gonna be the Natasha Denona palettes I picked up, the Dior palettes, the BH palettes, so on and so forth. So if you wanna see that, then just keep watching. Hey guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I'm a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys, particularly eyeshadow palettes, as you probably know if you're at all familiar with my channel. Your girl loves eyeshadow palettes, okay? So I've bought a lot recently. It's accumulated. So we're gonna start off with the more affordable palettes that I bought. And if you follow me on Instagram, you should know that I picked these up. But I made an order off of BH Cosmetics for a couple of palettes. If you don't know, like, I love luxury and high-end eyeshadow palettes, but when I can find a good affordable brand, I like to pick it up so that I can share that with you guys as well to give you options. And BH Cosmetics, spectacular. So I picked up two palettes. The first one we'll start off is not a newer one, but it's one that was heavily discounted. I believe they're going through with their travel series and redoing some of the older ones as far as packaging, but I believe they're keeping the formulas and colors from what they've said on the website. Anyways, I believe they're probably repackaging Smitten in Switzerland. This is one that I didn't have that I was interested in the color story. I literally got this for $6.80. So last time I checked, it was still available at that price on the website, so I will link it down below if you're interested. And boy, did I sleep on this palette. First and foremost, the travel series from BH Cosmetics, the 16 pan palettes, the best quality you will find at the price point. Like, I'm just being completely honest, best quality for the price. So anyways, when you open it up, this is what the palette looks like. And it was always a boring looking palette to me for whatever reason, but now that it's in my hand, it is gorgeous. If you are into neutral colors, you are going to love this. You have some green tone neutrals, some mauvey rosy tones, some neutral brown tones. Like, I don't know why this never appealed to me, because it is absolutely beautiful. So if you like neutral tones, stunning. I hope you can see how pretty those shimmers look. With the exception of like a couple of palettes, I haven't even used these palettes yet. This one hasn't even been swatched by me, but I mean, I trust BH. I feel like this one is gonna be fantastic quality, so I picked this one up and I wanted to let you know it was like dirt cheap right now. They also just recently added a couple new palettes in the travel series. They added Puerto Rico and Paris. I passed on the Puerto Rico because it just looked too warm for me. I wasn't interested in the color story, but this Passion in Paris was calling my name. This is the reason that I even placed this order, and I'll be honest, a lot of times BH Cosmetics does go on sale, so if you want to wait for a sale, I definitely recommend doing that. But I think the BH palettes are worth full price. I have no problem paying full price because you're getting such good quality for the price anyways, so the fact that it would go on sale for $7 is insane to me. So let's dive into the palette. Here is what the packaging looks like. You have a picture of Paris, and here are the shades. This is such a unique color story. It reminds me a little bit of the Scott Barnes Glamazon. I believe they've renamed it, but his cool tone palette, just in terms of the colorful shades. I'm really excited to use this. I feel like I can get some really fun looks. I almost used it today. I opted not to, but these shimmers look absolutely insane. This looks perfect for a deep smoky eye, and it's a unique color story. I don't think I really have anything quite like this in my collection. Can't get over the price. Hopefully the quality is going to be as good as I'm assuming it to be. And yeah, this is absolutely beautiful. So that's what I ordered off of BH Cosmetics. Let's go to a part of my haul that I think you guys are excited for. I bought not one, not two, not three, but four Natasha Denona palettes. And you're probably thinking, like, don't you already own all of the Natasha palettes? Believe it or not, I don't. I've always loved Natasha Denona, but in the early years of my channel, my mom and I would go halvesies on palettes. We lived in the same house, so we'd split the palette. And at this point, over the last couple of years, my mom and I have not been splitting very many things. I've just been buying them for myself, letting her use them. Sometimes she keeps them, doesn't give them back, and vice versa. So I've been slowly trying to repurchase palettes for when I move out, which hopefully is within the next few months. We'll see. But there are still some palettes that I'm missing. Like, I need to get the gold palette. I want a fresh one. I need a fresh Biba because my mom loves Biba, so I'll let her have that one. But anyways, they had a sale for some holiday. I can't remember. This was a few weeks ago. So I picked up some of the discounted palettes. Now, I don't think it's still going on, but they also did it again for the 4th of July. I should have picked up the palettes. I don't know what's wrong with me. Any hoosers, let me show you what I got. So, I mean, this was pretty exciting news. Natasha released her palettes from, I believe it was Holiday 2017. Now, my mom actually had these palettes. So I did tutorials and reviews on them, but they were hers. So I decided, since I didn't have these, that I was going to pick them up. So the first one that we have is Aries, which has this fun pop of blue. This was actually in my top 10 summer palettes. Unfortunately, this one has sold out, so you aren't able to get it. I believe these were on a discount as well. So not only did they come back out, I don't know why, maybe she had leftovers, but whatever, they came back out, but they were also discounted. This one is beautiful. I can see why it was the first one to sell out. So I'm really excited about this one. I mean, I've used it before, but I'm excited to have one of my own. And the other one that we have is Joya. And this one is still available on the website, around $38. I don't know the exact price at the top of my head. This is the one that I'm wearing today. It's really, really warm. So I mostly used this shade all over my lid and my crease. Then I topped it off with this shimmer shade right here, and then I deepened up just a little bit with the cranberry shade. It is gorgeous. I mean, this is a really pretty summer and holiday kind of palette as well. I'm very happy with this one. It was really fun to go back and play with this because honestly, it'd been a few years since I've played with these, and they are absolutely beautiful. Everybody loved these when they first launched. It's just been a while, and I'm happy that these resurfaced because they are beautiful. Okay, another one that we have here. Again, just got a fresh one. I'm having my mom keep the old crusty one, and I'm gonna take this brand new Lila palette with me. Now, I've been on and off with this palette. I loved it when it first launched, and then I wasn't so into the color story for a little while, but of late this year, I've really enjoyed this one. I got asked a lot why this wasn't featured in my top 10 or top 5 purple palettes video. It's because, really guys, it's not that purple. I mean, if you look at this, there's really only 3 true purple shades. The rest are flattering and complementary tones to purple, but it's not a purple palette. That's why it wasn't in my purple video. But nonetheless, it is beautiful. Again, it is a bit disappointing to me that it's not as purple as I would like for it to be, but it's a stunning palette. I do really like this one. Just know it's not a purple palette. You can get really beautiful rosy tones, bronzy tones, cool looks. I mean, it's a stunning palette nonetheless. I wasn't going to go without it, so I'm very happy that I was able to pick up a fresh one. This is one of her older palettes. This is not a new palette by any means, but the formula is spectacular, so I'm happy to have this one. Okay, my last Natasha Denona palette that I picked out is one that I think they are trying to get rid of. I remember it being at Sephora years ago. I was never interested in it, but it is on sale in the sale section of Natasha Denona's website for $45. Didn't have it. Nobody talks about it, but I wanted to pick it up. This is the eyeshadow palette 10. It's a 10 pan eyeshadow palette. It literally is the same packaging as her 28 pan eyeshadow palettes, but like cut in half. I don't know, I really like it. It's a nice handheld size. And I guess my taste in colors has changed over the last few years because now I'm into this color story. Now it is all shimmers. There are no mattes, but this is what it looks like. You have some very interesting cool tones here. You have a more neutral layer down here at the bottom. I don't know, I kind of just saw it on the website while I was ordering the other palettes. And as a collector, I was like, I'm gonna pick that up. So now it's here. Do any of you guys own this? I hear nobody talking about it. I need to play with this, so I feel like I have a palette nobody knows about, but here it is, and it's a really good price if you're into the colors. So that is what we got at Natasha Denona. We have some Dior to talk about. First of all, can we talk about the shipping? I ordered it like the morning, I can't remember the exact date, but let's say I ordered it Saturday morning and it came Sunday afternoon. Crazy, literally a 24-hour turnaround time. Now I haven't swatched any of these yet, but just the unboxing is, ugh. I've already opened them though. Reason being, Dior came out with a new Quint and it looked beautiful. Now, to my surprise, the palette that I saw online for Romantic Voyage, that's the one that I got, did not match the palette that I got. I was very, very confused. But at the end of the day, while I didn't get the palette that I really ordered or the color story that I saw, I kind of like this color story better. So this is what it looks like. It has some plummy tones to it. I'm actually really excited about this. It's very different than what I thought I was getting, but I am not mad about it. We'll see. It has some very nice taupey, plummy kind of shades. So I'm excited to play with this. I just felt like adding a new Dior Quint to my collection, and I saw this was the new limited edition one. So I picked it up, and then I opened it up, and I was like, this does not look like what I ordered. But I like it nonetheless. I'm not mad about it. Okay, and then I told you guys I wasn't gonna get this, but I was like on the website and I was like, I might as well get this one. You can see I got it from their Cruise collection. So I picked up the Cruise Look 022. I mean, this is stunning. It's a beautiful nude eyeshadow palette. Now, did I need this? No, but I don't need anything in this video. But these tones look absolutely beautiful. It looks even more beautiful than what I saw on the website. So I am really excited about this one. So pretty, nothing unique. You don't need to waste your money on it if you're trying to save your money, but I'm really happy with this one. It's always such a treat, a true luxury experience. We've got this beautiful Christian Dior ribbon. I have a Dior Show mascara sample, and in this cute little bag, a lip Dior Addict Lip Maximizer. Is this a baby lipstick? It's a baby lip gloss. Oh my gosh, I love the mini makeup. You guys, look, I love these Dior samples. I don't even use this, but on the shelf, I keep a cute little baby. Ah! Oh my gosh, I love it, I love it. See, you don't get this stuff while ordering off of Sephora. I try to order off, I don't know, it's hard, it's a balance because you get the Sephora points, but then you also get the luxury experience when you order from Dior. And at this point, I have a billion Chanel and Dior boxes in my room because I'm tacky like that, but I don't care, I put them on display. I spent a lot of money for that box. Next, these three items aren't packages. They're just the most beautiful eyeshadows that I've ever seen. So if you haven't heard me talk about Touch of Glam Beauty before, they are an indie brand, and the owner, she is very, very sweet. And she comes out with some of the most beautiful eyeshadows I've ever seen. So I placed an order off of her site or her store. She sells on Etsy because her Instagram was just showing off these beautiful colors, and I was like, I need that. So her shop is not cheap, so be aware of that, but totally worth it. So I got three different shades, so I'm gonna show you. So this first one is Bora Bora Ain't That Boring. And okay, it's gonna be a little bit washed out in this raw footage, but I of course will show you what they look like in better lighting. But this shift is incredible. It has like a purpley shift to baby blue shift. So that one is really beautiful. And then the other one that I got was Mint Mojito. Oh my gosh, these feel super duper creamy. So Mint Mojito is like a yellowish gold with some blue in there. I don't even know. I mean, hopefully you guys can see in the demo that I'm giving you, because in person, they are stunning. Okay, and here is the shade that is the reason that I made this order. I was seeing it everywhere. It's called Lucid Lavender, and not to be dramatic, but you guys need this shade. It's like a purple to green to blue to yellow. It is absolutely stunning, and her Instagram will literally sell it to you. It's, you know, not a cheap single eyeshadow, but it is worth every penny, all three of them. So stunning. It's going to a small company. It's going to a mom. So Lucid Lavender, Mint Mojito, and Bora Bora Ain't That Boring. They're all, I believe, Twisted Pack pastels is what the collection and formulation is. Highly, highly recommend. Okay, so as far as eyeshadows that I've recently bought, that is it. I'm going to show you a few new palettes that I've received in PR just because they are also new to the market. Well, not this one, but I wanted to show you this so that you know it's in my possession and that I will play with it in the next few weeks. This is the Sigma Ambiance Eyeshadow Palette. So I passed on this, but I really wanted it. I was very attracted to it. A PR company sent this to me on behalf of Sigma, and they sent me a few other Sigma things, but this is the one that I wanted to share with you since this is a eyeshadow haul. Here's the packaging. It's absolutely beautiful, and I think that this is a gorgeous color story. Sigma has some of the most beautiful color stories, but if you are a regular on my channel, you know that I don't like the Sigma formula. I do everything in my power to try and like their formula, but I find their shadows hard to work with. It takes me a lot of extra time, so I haven't tried this one, so we will see. My hopes are not very high with this one, but the color story looks beautiful. So I really, really hope it works out for me. I don't know, I'm really excited about this one. I got a few packages from ColourPop lately. They've been releasing so much, I can't keep track. So I did wanna share a couple of the new palettes that have come out. There are other things in the collection. So I got this collection, the High Tide and Fine Feathered. I'm just gonna show you the collection. This is a complete eye collection. So I'm gonna show you the High Tide collection first. So we have this blue palette, and I might not show you swatches of everything because there's some that I'm deciding if I'm going to give it away or not, but this is a really neat blue palette if you are on the market for all blue. I mean, I think ColourPop's got you. It's an affordable price. This one looks really beautiful. I actually might keep this one because I don't have a lot of true blue eyeshadows. They also came out with Wavebreaker Super Shot Shadow Set. I'm definitely not going to swatch these, but I believe these are repeat shades. But if you need a blue Super Shot Shadow, that's a good set. And they also have a couple of eyeliners, which I believe I own both of the colors. And then let me show you the Fine Feathered. This is the Fine Feathered, but I think this one's prettier. This is the one that I'm more attracted to. Looks so pretty. I love it. See, that was the one that I was going to keep, but now I don't know. And the Super Shocks in this one look beautiful, so I think I'm going to keep these as well. What are the shades? Plume and Bubbly. And then they also have some eyeliners. So that's the ColourPop palettes in that collection. I did get questions, not very many, but a couple questions about the Hello Kitty collection that came out. They came out with a second collection. So lots of little palettes came out. They also came out with some blushes and lip products that I need to dig into. I'm keeping this collection because it's Hello Kitty. I'm gonna show you the little themed quads. So they look really cute if you haven't seen them. If you're a Hello Kitty fan like me, I would have bought this had it not been sent to me because I love Hello Kitty. But we have Pineapple Cake, which is the yellow. I haven't watched any videos on this, so I can't speak on the quality, not even from a viewer standpoint. But they're teeny tiny little monochromatic quads. We have Teeny Keeny, which is going to be your warm tones. This one looks really cute. This is quite a well-rounded color story here to get a quick and dirty orange look. Then we have Coco Cutie, and here's another blue palette. A bit repetitive, as you know ColourPop can be, but really cute as a to-go blue palette. And then the last one, Cherry Sweet. Let's see what this one looks like. Hello Kitty's hugging a cherry, so cute. Ooh, this one is cute. I like this one. I feel like I'd use this one. Pinks, a pop of orange. Again, nothing new, nothing really too exciting color story wise. I just feel like ColourPop's done it all. There's no way they could really be too original anymore at this point. But there we are. Those are all of the palettes and the eyeshadows that have recently entered my collection. I'm really excited to play and get some looks done. I don't know that I'm gonna do dedicated tutorials with these palettes, but you might see quick reels show up on them as I use them. I'm trying to do more Instagram reel tutorials because it's just easier to get them out that way, and it's quick and dirty, and I don't have to worry about how many views they get. Is it worth my time, etc., etc. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this haul, and thank you to Sigma and ColourPop for sending those items in PR. I'm gonna have everything that was in this video linked down below if you are interested in purchasing. I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys, have a good one.